is not worthy of me, and he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Amen?
Amen.
That's what it says, that we're supposed to love Jesus more. A parent's love for Jesus. Barbara and I have lost two grandmothers. And Miss Jeannie lost one. We don't understand why. But a parent's love for a child can be so great. 1989, an 8.2 earthquake hit a country of Armenia. They said a father was digging at a schoolhouse where his son was. He dug for 38 hours nonstop. 38 hours, day and a half. People tried to discourage him. He kept asking, aren't you going to help me? Aren't you going to help me? On the 39th hour, he pulled back and found his son and 14 other children. His son said, I told them you'd always be there for me. What do you think about that? Who would have given up after 39 hours? A child's love for a parent can be a great one. There was a young boy one time had lost his mother. They couldn't afford a headstone. So he buys a scrap of stone and places it on a grave, tries to scratch out a word, my mother died last week. She was all I had. She said she would be waiting for me. A man saw this young boy out there, and he stopped and he noticed that the young boy ran to his mother's grave one evening. The man that saw him had put a tombstone, a grave, a tombstone at his mother's grave. And wrote on it, he loved his mother.
Man.
Man's love for a woman and a woman's love for a man. When two people get married, they become as one. That means they have to trust each other. They may not always get the things they want, amen, amen. Remember this, all battles are not worth winning.
Amen to that. Amen.
All battles are not worth winning. We're going to lose some. All battles are not worth winning in church. If it causes dissension in a church, it's not worth it. Amen. Man, you don't get to hang out all the time with your buddies anymore. And women, vice versa. Marriage is not a 50-50 anymore. It's 100-100. These people say, I'm going to shack up and see if I like it. I think it's okay with Virgil. Sometimes a sibling love can be great. This a youth leader one time asked one of his classes, which one of the Ten Commandments talks about parents? One little boy said, honor thy father and mother. He asked another one, are there any commandments that talks about brothers and sisters? They said, thou shalt not kill. Look at this. Your love for God must be greater than anything you can think of. Sometimes, y'all, many have to choose in our culture. A child may have to choose between God or bad parents. Wives may have to choose between submitting to Christ or submitting to husbands. You may have to choose between being with your children, family, or being with your birth family. As much as I love Barbara, my children, my brothers and sisters, I want them to know that they are number two in my life. Above everything else is the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We must love God more than we love ourselves.
Amen.
The Bible says the greatest love is loving God. We must love God so much that we would give it all for Him. What would you be willing to give up for Jesus? Would you be willing to give up your money, your house, your job, your car, future security. We must love God so much that we would give our lives for Him. Our lives for Him. In closing, Matthew suffered martyrdom in Ethiopia. He was killed by a sword. Luke was hanged in Greece. Peter was crucified upside down. James, the half-brother of Jesus, was thrown down a cliff 100 feet. He realized he was still dead. He beat him with a club. James, the greatest son of Zebedee, would be headed in Jerusalem. Andrew was crucified on an X-shape in Greece. Thomas was stabbed with a spear in India. Jude, the brother of Jesus, was killed with arrows. Matthias, the disciple that was picked by others to take Judas' place, was stoned by the Jews. Barnabas was stoned to death. Philip was crucified. Paul was beheaded. Friend, we have it so easy here in good old America.
Amen.
In closing, the day may come. The terrorists will be right in the back door. They could behead us. I'm not trying to scare you. We may have to take a stand. Jesus, or get killed. You remember the young girl in Columbine years ago? On her deny Christ and she wouldn't do it. Would you do that? Would you do that? In closing, let's go to Matthew 22. Matthew 22, verse 37, please. Matthew 22, verse 37. Start with 37. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Amen.
On these two commandments hang the laws and the prophets. You know, some people are hard to love. Amen. I don't. Well, Virgil, we ain't no choice. Look what they did to Jesus. What did he say? Father, they don't know what to do. As we get ready for revival, I'm going to challenge you this week to go out and bring as many people as you can that are lost, that don't go to church. I'm going to challenge you that you don't come at night, but come back Sunday night, Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night. Same God will be here every night.
Amen.
I'm
going
to challenge you. Bring your kids on Sunday night and have Billy's youth program back up. Once you lose a teenager, it's almost impossible to get them back. Been there and done that. As was 10, Brother Gordon.